Hi everyone. You may have seen that I've been playing with Altoid candy tins over the last couple weeks. I've posted a few things here and there on my social media. It doesn't take that long, and I like complicated crafts that don't take me too long to put together. And of course, these are perfect for putting a junk journal in, but they have so many uses. So what I'm focusing on is doing the top of the Altoids tin, and I've been working on Wizard of Oz journals, so this is the one that I was playing with and did for myself. And then when you pop it open, there's a mini Altoids tin inside. And it's just got some little Oz stuff, little charms and things I may use when I get to playing with the journal for the inside. But my object this week was to do the tops of the Altoid tins and maybe pick out some pictures to line the top, the inside cover and the bottom with. So that's the one I made for myself. And then because I was in Wizard of Oz mode, this is the one I made for Tracy Fox, because Tracy loves the ruby red slippers from Wizard of Oz. So it's funny, some of the Graphic 45 stuff has her in silver slippers like the book, and some have them her in the red like in the movie. And then when you open this, it's them in the poppy field. The illustration from the original book. And I've just got some ruby red buttons here and a little of Dorothy's gingham. And there's actually some sari silk underneath this, as well as layers of lace and things. So, that's the ruby red slipper one. So what I want to do today is put together a Van Gogh Altoid. And for those of you who don't live in the United States or don't get these easily, nowadays what I see, and they have them when you're checking out at the grocery store, they have a line of candy there. They have the wintergreen or the peppermint, and sometimes I can find the spearmint, but the green is rarer. So most of them that I have it are in these sizes, and I can't find the small ones in the tins anymore. In the stores, they've got another kind of container that's not exciting for crafters. But my wonderful Cog found 12 packs of the minis on Amazon, and I'll plop a affiliate link below if anybody's interested in grabbing some of those. So these are the smalls that go right inside the large ones, and this is what is inside. Is candy, curiously strong mints. Same with this. So I'm going to put this together. They all have. Okay, well, I will clean the candy out before I send yours, Christine, but I'm going to work with these two Altoid tins today. We can almost make the both of these at the same time because there's basically the same steps. As with so many projects that I work on, I cut a piece of canvas to fit the top. And you can do this with any tin, so I'm not going to go through and give you measurements. I cut it so that it's really not hanging off any side. And I think I cut one for the mini already. So while the corners may hang off just a little, it is fairly even and it does not have to be exact. And the next thing I'm going to do is take some cheesecloth. We call it cheesecloth here. I don't know if that's what they call it everywhere. England and Europe have a lot of different names for it, but I get this in rolls, and then this is actually layered over four times And often I will peel it apart and do single or double layers, but for this I'm going to do all four layers. And this came white. I douse this in some hot Lipton tea and throw it up on the clothesline, and it comes out this yummy antique-y color. There we go. So it does not have to be exact, and I can trim off the edges and such, but I'm basically trying to get them the same size. I know that it's going to fray before I'm finished, so having it be precision is not necessary. So there is the canvas and the cheesecloth. The next thing I want to do is find a piece of lace to put over this whole thing that is long enough to come down to this lip on each side. So I'm going to cut it approximately the height of it, but have it be longer. So I've cut that piece. Actually, that's a bit long, because that'll come right down to there. And there, yeah, I can trim that. One more notch, there we go. I'm actually gonna pull you guys out a bit here. Sorry for the shake. There we go. So that's got the larger one. The smaller one rather. I'm just gonna set that aside, and maybe that was bad. Maybe I should bring us back in. How about a compromise? There we go. Okay, lace. We have several pieces of lace that will fit. That is a bit bright. Oh, I like the dangles. I would be worried that they would be caught when I close it. Probably wouldn't, but I don't want to experiment on this one. My sari silk's wrapped up and everything there. Okay, that works. Wow, that's almost a perfect height too. And I just want that little flower centered there. So I will cut this probably just a little long. Yeah, and I'll be able to trim it up after I have attached it. So that is the base for these. And then I want to pick an image. And for this, I'm doing Van Gogh. I just reduced. This is a self-portrait that he painted. And I reduced a collage that I had and printed it small. I think that is a self-portrait in one of my digis. I want to put some sari silk underneath it. I got out some Van Gogh-y colored scraps. And I know that the size of this is going to be, I can see through and see the canvas there. About a little bit of sari silk sideways, break that up. This is some vanilla. And I'm just going to cut this so that when this folds down, I can trim it there and have it come just to the top of that lip too. So I'm not gluing everything and measuring it over to the edges, just this lace piece. And I'll go ahead and do that with this kitty corner, with the kitty corner sorry as well. So let me take glue. Let me take some Fabri-Tac, and I'm just going to put a tiny little bead, maybe just a little more around the edges than in the middle, because it's going to hold that cheesecloth on. There we go. Nothing sticking out too far. Works for me. And there's usually a right and wrong side to the lace, which I don't see until I'm in the bright light. I'm going to go with that as the right side. And I'm just going to put my Fabri-Tac, because it's shiny if it shows through. So when I do this, I try to just put the glue on the solid parts. And I will just flip this right onto there. And there's our base. And then, how did I do that? I cut it that way. I'm going, oh, there goes my spool of thread. I'm going to take a bead of this, and whenever I am putting Fabri-Tac underneath sari, I always smooth it with my finger so the blobs don't bleed through. Yeah, that's nice. And I think what I'll do now, well, you know what? I have a thin little piece of this gold. Oh, I like that on there too. All right, we'll put two layers of sari on. That's that butterscotch. More yellow than caramel. Somewhere along the way, colors of sari silk became flavors. So I'm going to go over to my sewing machine in just a moment when this glue dries, and I'm going to run just a few stitches right along here and get those tacked down the way I want, and kind of just put his picture there and zigzag right around it, and then I'll be back. Back from the sewing machine, and I have put a zigzag stitch in this side of the vanilla sari, and then fancy stitched up the gold sari and along here. And then I took Van Gogh's image and I stitched it kitty corner that way, so that the base looks like that. So the next thing I'm going to do is take this other fancy piece of sari, this little Van Gogh colored scrap, and I'm going to tack that down as well and go over and just put a quick stitch through it. The darker colored sari shows pretty stitches so well. Make sure I get the right side. That's reasonably straight. Because it's not. Because I know me. Okay. Let me just go through a stitch into this, and I will be right back with the next. And with that stitched on, you guys should know what's coming next. Buttons, gotta have buttons. And I'm just going to stitch those right on. Okay, we are almost there. So on the stitch, sorry, I just hand stitched on a few buttons. And the next thing I want to do is find a way, like I did with this, to anchor a bulb pin. A bulb pin is shaped like a bulb. And anchor it on with a charm onto the cover. So I have this tiny little, smaller than a postage stamp, piece of canvas. And I think I'm going to cover this with cheesecloth. Little piece there. And so we have our bulb pin. It opens like a safety pin. And before I put anything on it, I'm going to get it down through the top, down towards the bottom, and pull it through. Because we don't want to put stuff on it until it's anchored. And we also want to decide which way we're going to flop it. Let's see. Yeah, that'll work. We'll angle it and flop it that way. Okay. So I'm going to take, let's see how many beads we can fit in here. I've got some little wooden beads picked out. One. Two beads. I don't know if I'm going to get four beads on there. We might just have to go with two. Okay, well, there's one. And then I've got a sunflower charm picked out. It's so hard to use. Oh, I can use my phone as a magnifying glass. Maybe this is easier than I thought. Focus. Too funny. It's an optical illusion when you're watching the screen of what you're doing rather than watching what you're doing. I can never, I guess it's a depth perception thing. I can never get my hands to match what my eyes say they're doing on the screen. So I've got that jump ring on there. I'm going to plop that on the bulb pin, and the next bead. I actually had this video all set up to do just a little while ago. The sun was shining, and before I even got everything out to do this, the black clouds had covered the sky, and it was storming. I don't just mean dark, it was storming outside. Okay, so once again, I'm just going to keep placing this on here and imagining what that will be when attached. And do I like it? Yeah, I do like it up towards the top. It's going to need a little something down here to balance it out. That's okay. All right, so I want to glue this on. And I'm also going to cheat and put a dab of glue in back of that charm so it doesn't flop. It worked well on the scarecrow charm for my little tin. I did not anchor. I didn't anchor the slippers on Tracy's, but you know what I did? I sewed that on. I didn't even attach it with a jump ring. So they're going to lay flat because I attached the loop of the charm right to that. So we'll let that dry for just a minute, and hopefully that's dry. I've got some lace appliques. Don't want to do anything too girly for Van Gogh. On the other hand, he did, make sunflowers okay for boys. So, no, I think the first one. I think I like that there. Okay, and we're fussy cutting. I fussy cut more lace than paper these days. Ugh. That's a lot of lace. Maybe I'll take off that side woof. Yeah, I like that better. You know what else? It's awfully bright. I never knew this trick of distress inking lace until my friend Ellen came to stay with me. She picked it up and started dabbing away the lace. I said, "What are you doing?" She said, "It's too new. It needs to look old." I thought, "Well, that's brilliant." Okay. So there we go. So all that's left now is I am going to hold this exactly where I want it glued onto the Altoids tin. And I am going to trim each side, one side at a time, very carefully, so that when the canvas meets the edge, everything in the world sticking to my fingers, if I put this down, it will not go past that lip. And this is, I'm going to take just a little more off. And that's just fine. I'm going to do the same on the other side. That works really well. Okay, and then on the top, I'm just going to go straight across all this stuff, even with the canvas, the same distance or so off the edge, and then the same at the bottom. So whatever strips you might choose to have hang off your layers, I just use them as the future frame for my box. So that's all but done. I'm just going to get a piece of paper so I can make a mess. And I am basically going to cover everything on the back with Fabri-Tac. And what I'm not going to do is put any glue on the top and the bottom pieces that are hanging off, in this case, the sari silk. Put some on the side laces. little extra around the edges. So I have no glue on these little bits. It just gives me an extra few minutes to focus on getting everything else set down level, to where I want it. And I'm just going to go ahead and curl these edges, which I did put glue on, the lace edges, right over. If something sticking off doesn't stick right away, you can just go back and hit it again with the Fabri-Tac. There we go. Let me tell you, that anchors really, really well. I was surprised. I was prepared in the beginning to get out the E6000 epoxy, because that's usually what I use for anything metal that I'm gluing. And it was not needed, because the Fabri-Tac gets it done. Ooh, you know what? That's a little long. And now I'm going to be cleaning Fabri-Tac out of my titanium scissors. I would say something like the struggle is real, but my teenage... Oh, she's not a teenager anymore. My youngest informed me that that wasn't really cool anymore. Please don't say that, Mom. Bottom. I guess I should, yeah, check and see if it's the right height before I put the glue on. Okay, and we're trimming this up. I always say it's better to cut it too long. You can't grow more, but you can always trim more off, so that wasn't a bad thing. Just grabs right over the edge that way. Oh, I really like the way that's coming out. All kinds of little threads hanging out. That's okay. Gives it that shabby thing going on. All right, and one more. I got everything sticking to my fingers. One more piece here. I like the effect if you just put the lace or whatever's going on right over the edge a bit. It gives it that depth. Why does it look like that piece is sticking up at the top? I think because it is, maybe. Maybe we could get just a little more glue under there. There we go, that's about the right shape. Oh, maybe it's the lace. So there. Oh, you know what? I'm going to... Do you think we need to... I don't know. Maybe we don't need to attach that sunflower down after all. What fun. I'm going to let this dry, and any little pieces sticking up, I'll go back and tack again. So now what I have left to do for this is I'm going to take this piece of canvas. I'm going to glue this to it. I'm going to glue that to it. It is already sticking off either side in the correct length. I am going to sew this little piece of sari and stitch it somewhere right along there. And I have another little Van Gogh image here. So after I stitch this on, I'll stitch that on. And yeah, I have even picked out three more buttons. Maybe we'll put them on the side since we put them on the other side for the big one. So I'm going to stitch that all together and I'll be right back. So that is my quick little tutorial on how I am covering my Altoid tins. And inside this one is the smaller one. And I layered it and stitched it. Just as I told you, I put a little piece of folded lace so that there would be something on some side coming off the edge of this. And then inside, what I've done is I've put a beautiful little beaded medallion that came off the edge of a stunning sari piece of material that I got from India. And I cut it right off and put it in here because I know that if Christine decides to make a micro journal to go in the little tin, that she might enjoy having that. So that is that. I just jotted down, Carol had asked me about the sizes, or mentioned that she didn't realize the Altoids came in different sizes. She's in England. So I just jotted down the size of the large Altoids. And these are the approximate measurements in inches and centimeters. And then the same with the smaller Altoids. I don't have one to grab, but the smaller ones here. And if you're interested in these measurements, just pause the video and take a picture of it with your phone. Or if you're on your phone, screenshot this, and then you can refer back to the measurements. If you can't get an Altoids tin, I'm sure that there are other things that come in tins that you can probably get that are comparable, but those are the measurements. So thanks for popping in. These were so fun. I love playing with tins, and you know, there is no end to what you can use them for. So thank you for joining me, and I'll be back soon. Bye-bye.